The various chondrites contain more or less same components like chondrules, matrix, opaque faces such as metal and sulfide, calcium aluminum rich inclusions, and so on. However, the appearances of the various chondrite groups can be quite different. And here I will give a quick walkthrough to various chondrite groups and how these look like. I will start with, as these are the main components, light images of chondrules and matrix, as this is something that is not often shown. So all these are individual chondrules here, rather large, as these are from Allendis. So if someone is picking chondrules, this is how this should look like. And this is the corresponding matrix, although these are not individual bits of matrix because the matrix is much smaller. These are just bits of, well, these are bits of matrix, but not individual grains because the grains are much tinier inside here. So this is like how chondrules and matrix look like when we pick them, for example, under the microscope. Now also, the last 3D image from Ivuna, as this is arguably the most important metrite, it is the type metrite for the CI chondrites, and the CI chondrites are those that have the same composition as the solar photosphere, except for the volatile elements. Now the CI chondrites are those that contain mostly only matrix material. There's almost none of the other components I just mentioned, but this is an exception here. They consist 99% of matrix. And we can already see here that this small bit here has a very fine-grained structure. And we see this again when we look at chip again of Ivuna here, very fine-grained silicates, is also olivine or pyroxene or so. But there can also be these nests of magnetite, which might be secondary. There's magnesium sulfates, iron oxides, and so on. But the scale down here shows us that this is all, again, highly fine-grained. And then let's look at something we might call a typical chondrite or typical carbonaceous chondrite, which in this case is Efremov CV chondrite. And here then we see the individual chondrules, quite large ones, as the CV chondrites have up to, now on average, 900 micron sized chondrules. And we can see in Efremovka as well, there's some elongation here, so most of the chondrules are sort of elongated in some way. Then there's matrix in between, fine-grained material, so there's lots of chondrules, maybe 60-70 volume percent. Most of the remaining is then the matrix. And the chondrules containing very often metal, sulfide, or they have a structure, there's some sort of coating, there's a finer grained rim here sometimes around. We can also look at a phase map of Efremovka, and a phase map means that the various phases like olivine, pyroxene, mesostars, and so on get individual colors. And what we can see then is that most of these chondrules have some sort of zonation. For example, up here there's an olivine core, and this is surrounded by a pyroxene rim. And this is something we see in most of the chondrules, like here, like here, like here, this one, this one. Actually, really, almost all of the chondrules have this kind of mineralogical zonation. And in fact, carbonaceous chondrites have about 80% or 80% of their chondrules have this kind of zonation. Although there are also chondrules that don't have one, some like this here, for example. Now, this is another CV chondrite with more matrix. This is Allendis, so there's more matrix here, but there are also chondrules here. Again, they have various appearances. This is not the topic here, these various appearances. There's type 2 chondrules, for example, iron-rich. The others are more magnesium-rich. Again, we can look at a map here, although this is not a phase map. This is an overlay of various elements here. And in this, we can see that the calcium and aluminum are yellow and white here, and then we can see that these objects now are in fact calcium aluminum rich inclusions, and they are a little less rounded than the chondrules sometimes, as is the case down here in the CAI. They have more rect outline, which is quite typical as CAIs are condensates, and CVs have most of the CAIs, so we should expect to find them in there about 3 to 4 volume percent. Then this is a CK chondrite, another one, and we can see already that this looks quite different from the CVs. So this is a CK4, it means it's slightly metamorphosed, since Already harder in here to spot individual contours. So here are some contours. There is one, for example, also there's less metal. So this indicates already some difference in between the chondrites. This is CK5, so again a CK, but of higher pathologic types, and it's even more difficult to find spot individual chondrules in here, so there might be one in here, but there's a lot of recrystallization going on in this meteorite, and this is why, or this recrystallization destroys all the chondrules, and we don't see them anymore here. This CM chondrite, Murchison, here again, or here now, chondrules are more easily seen. Murchison usually of type 2, so this is aqueously altered. So there are all the individual chondrules. There's a lot of matrix chondrules, are small, maybe 150 micron in size. And if we look in more detail, we can again see here these individual chondrules and so. And what is very typical for CM chondrites is that the chondrules often have this kind of dust rims around them. And most of the chondrules, when you look at these also here, all of these chondrules have these dust rims around them. So also here there's the chondrule, and then here there's this dust rim around these chondrules, which are very, very typical for CM chondrites. The other chondrites also have dust rims around the chondrules, but not that thick and abundant as in CM chondrites. Now there's the CO chondrites, so CM and CO form a clan like CV and CK. This means they, for example, they also have small chondrules, many chondrules, so there are, this is full with chondrules, these are all chondrules, as said, quite tiny chondrules, but really many chondrules, so it's difficult to find actual matrix in here. And this is interesting also because this has here some still fusion crust on this particular piece of meteorite here. And these are CR chondrites, it's starting a new clan, so there's CV, CK, CM, CO. Now there's a clan that's CR, CH, and CB chondrites. Those are the one I'll show next. The CR chondrites, or this clan, chondrules can be again easily identified. So here are all the chondrules. This, of course, is a very nice big chondrule, and also the matrix in between is again more easily spotted. CR chondrites are also quite famous for there are lots of metal. So there's lots of metal here all over the place within chondrules, concentric in chondrules, but also within the matrix, quite a lot of metal. And as we can see here as well, chondrules can also occur as fragments, so constant, always roundish, like this one is also maybe sort of a fragment here. This one certainly is a fragment, and so on. So this is seen in all the chondrites, that chondrules are also fragmented. This is a CH chondrite. This is related to the CR chondrite. Some think that CH maybe have formed from an impact on a parent body. And here are again the chondrules, quite fragmented. This one, this is certainly a fragmented chondrule. This one as well. This is quite roundish chondrule. For CH chondrites, these cryptocrystalline chondrites, chondrules are quite typical, whereas for the others it was the porphyritic chondrule. So this is a porphyritic chondrule. These are more rare in the CH chondrites. CH chondrites are also characterized by, for example, this kind of CAIs, which are remelted. So this was likely a normal CI. It was remelted and now looks like a chondrule, so it's sort of chondrule CAI. And of course, CAIs are very famous, that's why they're called CH, for their many, many metal grains. So all the whites, but it's all metal. So there's massive amount of metal in the CH chondrites. H stands for high iron, whereas in the other carbonaceous chondrites, the second letter always is for the type meteorite. And the same is true for Ishijevo. There's even more metal. So these are all, this is just all metal. Sometimes there's lumps of other meteorite material, might be CR-like material, for example, in there. There's then also chondrule fragments here. Individual chondrules are harder to spot, but this is a lot of metal. And there's almost no matrix in CB or CH chondrites. And the matrix is just very tiny in between all these grains and often highly hydrated, so secondarily altered. Let me go to the ordinary chondrites. So far this was all carbonaceous chondrites, now these are ordinary chondrites. This is an ordinary chondrite that looks from, well, the components similar to carbonaceous chondrites. However, the ordinary chondrites have much more chondrules. So as you can see here, there's lots and lots and lots of chondrules. So 60 to 80 volume percent of ordinary chondrites consist of chondrules here. So, and this is what we can see here, lots of chondrules, and it's an edge chondrite. There's also high metal, which means there's also lots of white metal grains in this meat right here. This was an edge chondrite, this is now an L chondrite, so it has less iron. So again, lots of chondrules, so this seems to be a compound chondrule here. In between these two, there's a chondrule, this is a chondrule. So most of the ordinary chondrites is chondrules. It's very difficult to find matrix. And then of course there's also metal in this ordinary chondrite. Now this is 3.A, so these were pathologic type 3, I just showed, it's now pathologic 3.8, so it's a bit higher metamorphic type, and we can already see some the chondrules, well, still very good to see, but it might start some thermal metamorphism, but lots of chondrules again, so all these are chondrules, there's almost no matrix, and again, lots of metal here. And we can see this also in the face map, again, this time of an ordinary chondrite, but importantly, in contrary to the face map from the CV chondrite, there are not as many zoned chondrules. And this is what is quite typical for ordinary chondrites, that the chondrules themselves, only half of them maybe have this mineralogical zonation. Maybe this one here has olivine in the core, pyroxene at the rim. This one here might look a little bit, this one here, so they are quite, but it's about half, so down here, so if you study in detail, you'd find about half. Then the ordinary chondrites, most of the ordinary chondrites are of high pathologic type. This again, L chondrite, this time of pathologic type 5, and here you can see there's, you can't see any chondrule. So there's some metal here, of course, but everything else is just typically feldspar or pyroxene or something like this, but there's no chondrules, no structure at all. Everything is completely recrystallized. And this is again seen here in this L6, so even higher petrologic type, no chondrules at all. Maybe this was some chondrule, but this is more guesswork than really knowing something. So this is entirely metamorphosed and recrystallized. This then LL chondrite, again of lower pathologic type, so we can again see chondrules. But compared to the H chondrite before, there's not as much metal in here because it's LL, low iron, low metal. And this is what we can see. Lots of silicates, chondrules, of course. Again, most chondrules, difficult to spot any matrix, but much less metal as in the H chondrite. Then the enstatite chondrites, they again have a lot of, well, they are from the abundance of chondrules and matrix, they are similar to the ordinary chondrites, but their mineralogy is different. They have much more silicon, so their magnesium-silicon ratio is much lower than ordinary chondrites, or significantly lower. And the chondrules, so there are lots of chondrules, again, that we can see all over the place, and this is mainly pyroxene, as we will soon see, and again, there's lots of metal in here because it's an H chondrite, so again high iron. So if we now look at the face map here, we can see it's almost all blue. The purple is the metal and the blue is all the pyroxene. There's also some chondrule, there are some chondrites that have this kind of mineralogical, where we can see the mineralogical zonation, like here for example, or here. Interestingly, if you look in 3D, which is not shown here, but if you look in 3D, most of the chondrules, but also about half of the chondrules have this mineralogical zonation. We just can't see it here because the rim of these chondrules is very thick. So if you look at these chondrules, pyroxene, these enstatite chondrules, they have a core in the center and then a very thick rim of pyroxene around this core. So if we cut this chondrule, most of the sections will only show pyroxene. All right, so this is a as said, quick walkthrough all the different chondrite types and how their different appearances look like and their various contents of the components.